A petition with almost 20,000 signatures will be presented to Disabilities Minister Jenny Macklin today, urging the government to fund services for people with vision loss as part of the National Disability Insurance Scheme. Guide Dogs Australia has spent 2 months raising awareness of the campaign. The key message being how important it is for people with impaired vision to be able to get around on their own. Today is also International White Cane Day. And joining me now to talk about the campaign from Guide Dogs Australia is Jane Bryce and Nicole Holmes, who is also a cane user. Good morning, welcome to both of you.
Good morning.
Jane, firstly, if I could start with you. Put simply, the NDIS is a new funding scheme for people with significant and permanent disability. Why are you having to go to the federal government with a petition?
Well, to mark International White Cane Day today, we're calling on the government to make sure that we get fair and equitable funding for people who are blind or vision impaired so that they can be independent and be able to get around.
Is this a preemptive mood or a move, or is there some indication that they won't fund you correctly?
It's both. There's no guarantee that people who are blind or vision impaired are going to be covered under the NDIS, so we're making sure that the government gets a very clear message so that people who are blind and vision impaired can be independent, so they can get to school, they can get to university, they can get to work. Also, vision loss is on the increase. So an Access Economics report says that by 2020 we're expecting 800,000 people with vision loss.
But that's more than double, almost three times the figure now. Is there a proportional increase, or are these just raw numbers? Why is there an increase?
We're seeing an increase in eye health issues. Diabetic retinopathy is on the increase. Macular degeneration is on the increase. So we're just seeing an ageing population and an increase in people with vision loss.
Nicole, the mantra of many vision impaired people is that mobility makes them less of a burden and better contributors to the community. How has that happened in your case?
Yes, Ron, that's very true. I've had my vision impairment since birth, and I'm not able to rely on any of my vision. It's no use, so I have to use my other senses. And so mobility training from Guide Dogs Australia has been crucial right from about age five, starting to use the cane, right through to orientation to my school, then to tertiary education and in the workplace, as well as my social activities. Without mobility, I wouldn't be able to get from home to the bus stop and on trains and around the city or wherever I need to go.
Well, it's a credit to Guide Dogs because they keep their issues out there, and we're very well aware of Guide Dogs, but perhaps the cane is a little less, there's less awareness about it in the community. How do the two different modes of getting around for you work? Are there disadvantages and advantages in both?
There certainly are disadvantages and advantages to both. The cane comes into contact with obstacles, and then I'm able to move around them. So it can detect surface changes going from concrete to pavement. It can locate stairs for me, and so just being able to use that out in front of you just gives you that bit of protection as you're walking around, and enables you to walk quite confidently and independently around an environment, whether it be busy CBD or just down a suburban street.
Jane, what are you wanting from the government today?
We want fairness and equity for people with vision loss. So we want people who are blind and vision impaired to be able to be independent, to get out about, reduce the risks associated with vision loss. So reduce falls, reduce hip fractures, reduce depression, making sure that the government funds services, long canes, other services to keep people with vision loss independent.
Nicole, what are your fears about any changes to funding from the government?
I think as long as people with a vision impairment are covered under the NDIS, that would make me extremely happy.
Get access, of course it does.
Yes.
Very good on you. Jane Bryce and Nicole Holmes from Guide Dogs Australia, and your petition.
Thank you
very much for coming and having a chat to us today.